Okay.
Hi, I'm Vanessa. This is Reforma Flow 1.5. Before we start, has anyone any injuries or concerns they would like to tell me before we start? No? Okay, wonderful. So we're starting off with footwork, warming up with two reds, one green, and a yellow. We have our weights in our hand, alongside our body, bent at the elbows. We have our toes on the footbar, parallel, hip-width distance apart. And as we push the carriage away, we're pushing our weights up towards the ceiling and bringing our elbows back down beside us for elbow taps. Making sure that we're engaging our stomach muscles, our glutes, and our hamstrings as we stand the carriage out. Making sure that our legs are straight, but not blocking the knees at the same time. Going for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, one, last one, pulling the carriage out and bringing your arms down alongside your body. Bring the carriage halfway in for controlled pulses. 2 inches in, 2 inches back, with 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, extend the carriage out and bring it back into the stop bar. Okay, we're putting our toes still on the foot bar, in the same hip distance apart, joining our heels together in the Pilates V, bending our arms for bicep curls as we push the carriage out. Making sure to try and engage the inside of your leg muscles when you extend that carriage out. Good. Good, we're going for 8, 7, really engaging those glute muscles as you extend the carriage out. Five, four, three, two, one, hold that carriage out and bring the carriage halfway in. You can relax your arms alongside your body for pulses for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Extend the carriage out and bring it back in. Great, good job. Placing the heels at the edges of the footbar. The feet are externally turned out. Our arms are out to the side with our weights facing, our hands facing, palms up towards the ceiling. Breathing in, breathing out, pushing the carriage away and bringing the weights to meet each other. And back out to the side. Or chest fly. Really make sure to extend those legs out straight. Feel the inside of your muscles. Try to feel like your inside of your muscles are trying to connect together like a magnet. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring the carriage in halfway for pulses for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, extend the carriage out and bring it back in. Placing the toes in the middle of the fupa. Our arms are up above our head, the shoulder line, pushing the carriage away and dropping the heels underneath the fupa. At the same time, bringing your weights above your head for a tricep press. Back up onto the tippy toes and bring the carriage back into the foot stopper. Back out. Feel the stretch in the back of the calf muscles as you lower those heels underneath the foot bar. Good. Trying to maintain a neutral spine and pushing your rib cage down towards the back of your spine. Going for six. Five. Are you able to drop your heels underneath the carriage and then back up? Oh yeah, yeah. So yeah, maybe move down so there's not so much pressure on you up your shoulders onto the shoulder pads. How's that feel? Yeah, that's better. Yes, you don't want to have too much pressure on the shoulder pads. Okay, three more. Two and one. Hold that carriage out. We're going into alternating the legs with the arms for full prancing. Good. Really feeling that stretch in the calf muscles. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one, up onto the tippy toes, bending your knees and bring the carriage back in. Okay, great. You can put your weights to the side and lower the head press. We are going to go into bridging. I will remove a yellow spring for you. We're placing our heels on the foot bar, parallel, hip distance apart. Our arms are alongside our body on the mat, and we're slowly tilting the pelvis in towards your spine and lifting those hips up, articulating the spine up towards the ceiling into a high bridge, and then lowering back down, bone by bone, vertebrae by vertebrae at a time. Once again, tilting that pelvis in, lifting those hips up, slowly up into a high bridge and lowering back down. We have an option here to add magic circle. So on the next one, lifting up and lowering back down, vertebrae by vertebrae. If you want to add the magic circle just for a little bit more of a challenge, you can place that in between your knees, on the upper part of your knees. Once again, our legs and our feet are parallel and our toes are on the foot bar. So we're once again articulating the spine up, pulling the hips up into a high bridge, just to give a little bit more of a challenge with the magic circle. Good. Giving the magic circle a squeeze as you lift it up into a high bridge and lowering back down. You should feel your glute muscles, your hamstrings. keeping our hips in line with one another. Two more. Two. One. Hold this last one up into the air, keeping your hips up. We're pulsing our hips up towards the ceiling for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold that up high, and we're squeezing the magic circle for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great. And lowering back down. Good job. Okay, so now we're putting our heels, placing our heels on the hoofer, and our toes are externally turned out. We're hinging up into a high bridge, trying to keep the carriage still, and lowering back down. Good. Hinging back up into the high bridge, and back down. 10. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, last one, keeping your hips up. Again, for the pulses up, pulse those hips up towards the ceiling for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And for squeezes for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great. And lowering back down. Good job. Can you give yourself a good quick little squeeze, your knees in towards your chest, before we move on to the last bridging exercise. Okay, so next one, we're placing both legs inside the circle this time, above your knees, and that our heels are on the footbar, parallel. Our arms alongside our body, hinging up into a bridge. From being up in the bridge, you're pushing the carriage away. Straighten those legs and keeping those hips up at the same time, and bringing it back in to the footbar. When you bring the carriage in, try to really lift your hips up even a little higher if possible. For 10. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Bring it in, keeping those hips up. And we're going to pulse our knees outwards in the magic circle for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And last of all, for pulses up for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great. Good form. Good job, girls. Okay, so taking that magic circle, the left leg can hang over the footbar, and put the magic circle onto the right foot, pushing down, flexing your foot, pushing down the magic circle on your foot, so it's flexing your foot. So you get a really nice stretch with your hamstrings and the back of your leg muscles and your glutes. Opening it up towards the side, holding with one hand. Feel the stretch on the inside of your leg muscles. Good. Crossing over your body, changing hands, good, to stretch the outside of your leg muscles and your glute muscles. Good, you can put that left foot across your right leg to give yourself a little bit of a figure four stretch. Breathing into that stretch. Should feel good after the bridging. Okay, let's change legs. Magic circle on the left foot. And the right leg can be hanging over to your bow. Opening out towards the side, holding with crossing it across your body. A stretch for the outside of the muscles of your legs. Great. And placing that right foot just above your knee for a figure four stretch. Good. And when you're ready, we will move on to arms and straps. Okay. Take one spring away. I'm taking one red spring away. So now we have one red and one green. Placing our hands in the short straps, putting our legs into a tabletop position. Our arms are shoulder distance apart at 9 degrees, and we're breathing in and breathing out as we push the arms down towards the side of our bodies and back up and down and up. We have an option here to add a chest lift if you like, as well as the second option, if you want a more of a challenge, to adding your leg extension to both legs to 45 degrees and back into tabletop position. Good. Really trying to keep those ribs pushed downwards. Your hips are in line with one another. Making sure that you're not arching your back as you're extending your legs out to 45 degrees. You feel like it. So maybe lift up your leg, maybe not as low as 45, just a little bit higher, just so you don't feel it's not going to have. Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Okay, let's do 5, 4, 3, 2, and on the next one, keeping those straps beside your body, doesn't have to be touching, but just hovering above the mat. We are going to begin pumping our arms for hundreds. You can either keep your legs at 45 degrees or in tabletop position. So we're breathing in for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Within 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, In for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're done. Bring your legs into your knees in towards your chest. You can relax for a little bit. Give yourself a little bit of a stretch. Squeezing your legs in, rolling on your back. It's a goodie. It gets your abdominals working. Okay, so next one. I'll grab that, the straps for one more time. The short straps. Yes. Yes, red and blue, absolutely. Yes.
I mean, it's great, but...
No, absolutely. And I love that you speak up to tell me. Okay, so let's try that. The hands are in the short straps, tabletop position, arms at 90 degrees, legs at tabletop position, bringing our arms down towards the side of our body, out to the side, and up back to 90 degrees for arm circles. Once again, you do have the option to add a chest lift if you like. Now after this next one, if you'd like to add legs, we can. Add leg circles. So when you bring your arms down, extend your legs out at the same time to 45 degrees. Out to the side, exactly as your arms does, and back up to 90. Down, out, and up. Good. For 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, good, and 1, good. Okay, bring your chest, your legs down, hang up with straps. Bend, twisting, giving a good twist of your spine, bring your legs over to the right and looking the opposite direction for a good spinal stretch. And again on the other side. Okay, good. So we are going to hop off the reformer for a moment, grabbing our short box and placing the short box and the shoulder pads. We just have one blue screen. We're going into planking. So we're kneeling up towards the box. Our elbows are placed on the box. You can either place your feet on the gray platform, or if you want to add more of a challenge, up onto the footbar. So pushing the carriage out to a plank position, holding for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we're moving our elbows forward and back for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Holding again for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And once again with the elbow moves for 5, 4. Really pulling up your belly button towards your spine to keep your posture in a nice neutral position. For 1. Okay, holding for 5, 4, 3, 2, One, this is the last one, and once again with the elbows for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great job. Okay. Give yourself a good stretch. Over the box. Good job. When you're ready, we're going to the next round. Are you ready? Okay, up onto our elbows once again, going, pushing the carriage out and into a plank position. We're holding again for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Next time with knees, we're bending our knees in and out, in and out. Three more, three, two, good, one, and holding again for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and again, one more time with the knees in and out. If you bring knees to stop, please, you have to listen to your body. 2, and 1. Good, you can bring it back in. Do the child's pose stretch. Don't you love planking? It's the best. Okay, you ready for one more round? We're going.
No, she knows that planking's not my
favorite. Okay, so we're going to do the exact same thing, but just adding pikes. So when you're ready, pushing the carriage back out. Yeah, we'll just go straight into it. I won't do it to you this time. We won't hold it for 5. Let's just do some piking. Okay. Good. Okay, let's go for 5 more. 5. Really pushing up at the hips as you go into that pike. Lifting up through your belly, your stomach muscles. Up. Great. Good. 4. 3. Did I say I need 5? 2. Nice and long. And 1. Hold, 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 hold. Good. And you can bring in the carriage back in. Good job. Really good form. Stretch over the box. You might also want to sit up and hold the outside of the fupa and arch back to give yourself a little bit of a stretch of the abdominals. Yeah. Good. Great. Okay, let's go over to the springboard. We need to put our yellow springs at either a 9 or 8, so shoulder height. So it's, yeah, in line with your shoulders. There you go, that's really good. Okay, so we're holding, we're facing the springboard to start with, and we're holding with our palms facing down. You might want to step back a little bit so there's just a little bit of tension in the springs. We have a nice neutral posture, pulling up in our belly, and we're breathing in and breathing out for chest expansion. So we're pushing both arms down towards the side of our body and back up. You should feel your collarbone opening up as you push your arms back, and try to feel your shoulder blades trying to engage together. This is really good for your posture. Good. Breathing out. Okay, so on the next one, let's try it with head rotations to the right. So when you hold the springs down, the to the right and back up. So both arms down, that same, just exactly what we're doing, but just adding a head rotation. Nice. Three. Two. Very nice. And one. Okay. So now turning our hands up towards the ceiling, our palms towards the ceiling. We will step back, our elbows are into our waist for bicep curls. We can add a squat to this if you like. You want to give yourself a little bit more of a challenge. Holding the squat, making sure that we have that weight of our body in the heels of our feet, not in our toes. Good. Nice form. Nine for eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One, and you can let go. Okay, turn around. Bring it up. No, sorry, not turning around. Not yet, almost. So we're just turning our palms around, our hands around, and we still have our elbows in at our waist for tricep pulls. There we go, yes. Good, keeping that spine nice and neutral. Our abdominals are pulled up in towards the spine. Good. For eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three, two, and one. Nice. Now we're going to do a turnaround facing the middle of the room. Okay, so we are doing a reverse chest expansion now. Our hands are facing outwards. We're leaning a little inch forward, and we're bringing our arms up and back down towards our side. Good. Bring it back up. Good. Really keeping our core engaged, abdominals engaged to keep that spine neutral. Good. If you want more tension with the springs, you need to step out a little bit further. But if you want less, it's better to stay in closer to the springboard. Let's do three more. Three, two, and one. Good. How are we doing?
Awesome.
Okay. All right. So let's do one last one here on the springboard. We have the option of stepping 1 foot forward into a larger stegged lunge. Our arms are out towards the side for like hug a tree. Okay, so it's still a little bit of a hinge forward, and we're bringing the hands together to join in front of us. Good. For eight. Seven. Six. Five. And making sure that we're not pushing our shoulders forward as well when we do this, keeping them in line. Four, three, two, and one.
Good.
All right. We are done with the springboard.
Yeah.
Not with the class yet.
No.
Okay, you can put the springs back up at 11. So we're done with that now. And we're going to move on to the chair. So I'm going to put this at one spring at three. Okay, this one's already, you might want to put this here. And we are going to sit facing the back of the room. So, and you have the option to have your inside leg bent on the chair, or you are going to lie down onto your hips, so your hips are aligned with each other. And for side bends, your left arm is on the foot pedal, and you will push the pedal down and bring it back up with a straight arm, and lifting the side of your torso up. Beautiful. We want to make sure that we're keeping our hips in line with each other. You have an option to hold the chair like you are now. Put your hand above behind your head or alongside your body. Let's do three more. Two. Good, nice one. And next one, bring it down and then bring it up halfway for little pulses. Four, five, four, three, two, one, and bring it back up. Okay, from here we're going to go into a mermaid stretch. Since we're facing that the same way.
Oh.
Yeah, just you can, no, it's fine. So you can, for the mermaid, you can keep your inside leg bent up on the chair and the outside leg alongside the chair. So pushing as you push the pedal down, we're bringing the outside arm up, stretching that hand up and over above our heads for a nice side stretch. And bringing it back up, bring that inside arm up and over and stretching over the other side. Good. Let's do it one more time. Pushing that hand onto the foot pedal, pushing that down, bring the outside arm up and over. A good side stretch. Very nice. Back over. Inside arm up. Stretch the other side. Good, very nice. One more time. Over. Good. And back up on the other side. Okay. Breathing into that side stretch. Okay, the next one, we're bringing that arm down, over, do just one more. And this outside arm, we're going to join that other hand onto the foot pedal and push down for three times. Push down and push up, keeping those arms straight and pushing down. You should feel a really nice stretch in your back. One more time. And back up. Good. Okay. Okay, so going into swan from here. Let's turn around before we go onto the other side. And we're placing our hips towards the edge of the chair. Pushing both hands down and then slowly lifting the upper torso up, getting, yes, keeping those arms straight and lowering back down. Nice extension. Up and down. Five more. Five. Very nice. Keeping those legs nice and active, the muscles, and down. Three.
two. Good. And one more. Up. Good. And back down. Okay. Beautiful. Okay, slowly bring that foot pedal back up. You might want to give yourself a nice little cat stretch before we move on to the other side. So facing the front of the room, either with your leg bent on the chair or both out to the side, lying on the side of your hip. Great, with both hips in line with each other, pushing that pedal down for the side bends and bring it back up. Good, keeping those hips perfect, those hips are nice and aligned. And back up. Good, the option with the arms, holding the chair or alongside your body. Good. For five, really engaging your abdominals in, that helps with the control of your hips. Four. Three. Two. And one, holding up and bring it halfway down for just a little pulse for five. Four. Three. Two. One. Beautiful. And back up. Good job. Okay, let's get into the nice stretch, my favorite, the mermaid stretch. Okay, pushing the pedal down, lifting that outside arm up, 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 and over your head to feel that really nice stretch alongside the body. Beautiful. Lifting back up, bringing that inside arm up and over to the other side. Good. One more time. Up and over. That stretch and over to the other side. Okay, one more time. Good, breathing into it and over to the side. Good, that's the last time. Over to the side, bringing both arms over and placing both hands onto the foot bar, pushing down the foot bar to feel the stretch along the outside of our backs, and bringing, lifting the pedal up, keeping those arms straight and pushing it back down. Good. Back up. And last one. Down. And back up. Great, beautiful job. You can stand up and try it if you want to give yourself another little bit of a cat stretch to feel the lower half of your back and your spine stretch out. Give yourself a little stretch before we go back onto the reformer. Or feet and straps. I'll help you do that. Okay, so we did two reds. You have your head rest up, if it's still not up, and we're placing our feet in the large straps. Up until 90 degrees. That feet are parallel. And we're just starting with lower and lifts. Good. Keeping our spine in a neutral position. Trying not to lower too far because you do not want to have that arch in your body when you're lowering your legs. You don't want to lift the middle of your back up off the mat. Good. Five, really using the glute muscles and now hamstrings to push down the straps. Good. On the next one, let's externally turn our feet out so we're in the Pilates feet and really engaging the inside of our legs for 5, 4, 3, 2, one. The next one, let's bring our feet in to a tabletop position for frog. Bring it in and out. Good. Extending it out to 45 degrees. Good. When you extend your legs out, engage those inside of the muscles of your legs together. Next one, let's bring it back up to 90 degrees and let's pull those straps so we're flexing our feet to give ourselves a good stretch along the back of our legs. And opening out into a V or a wide V for a nice stretch, feeling the inside of our leg muscles stretching, rocking side to side if you like to massage the lower half of your back. Nice. Good. Joining our legs together again, going into leg circles, pushing our legs down, up, and around. Ten. Nine. Eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and let's reverse that direction. Good. This is a really good stretch for your hips, your legs. Very relaxing. Eight. Seven. Six, five, four, three, two, and one. Make it a good last circle. Let's join our feet together. Bend our knees and bring our feet down into the carriage for a nice butterfly stretch, opening our arms out to the side and just laying them drop open, breathing into that stretch. And when you're ready, you take the straps off our feet. Since we have the bosus on the chair, we'll just come to the edge, the end of the reformer facing the footbar. So we're up against the reformer. We're going to place our hands onto the mat, onto the reformer, in the carriage, and push the carriage forward. feel a nice stretch in your back. And bring it back in, arching. For a cat stretch, really sucking in your stomach and giving your back a good stretch. Pushing it out one more time. So you're pushing it out so your spine becomes into a neutral position. And then you're bringing the carriage back in and scooping in the belly to feel that really nice stretch alongside your back. One more last time, pushing it out, the carriage. Good. Do you feel the stretch? Yeah, good. Bring it back in. Rolling back up to a standing position. Rolling our shoulders back a couple of times, one more time, and then the opposite way. Okay. And you are done.
Yay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you.